settled down a lot after the picnic incident. Rodney wasn't kind per se, but he went back to mostly acting as if he was a roommate. I took care of baby pretty much completely on my own. After a few more weeks went by, I returned from maternity leave and started working again. Baby still struggled with sleeping at this point. And it was really difficult on me when I had to deal with the lack of sleep while working too, but I was making it work. We pick up our story when baby is 5 months old. You look exhausted. Why don't you go to bed early tonight and I will put baby to sleep? No, it's okay. I'm fine. He should go to bed early tonight anyways. He didn't take a good nap today. Babe, I got it. I can handle putting him down for one night, I promise. I'm just watching the football game tonight, so he can hang out with me until he falls asleep. Go ahead and go to bed, okay? If you're sure, I am really tired. If you're having trouble with him though, please just let me know and I'll come get him. He can be a jerk about bedtime sometimes. I got it. Go to sleep. I laid down in bed and left the door open so I could see what was happening. Even though I was completely exhausted, I could not let myself fall asleep. Rodney had never offered to put baby to bed. And I was nervous it wouldn't go well. After a little while, I saw Rodney walk up the stairs holding a sleeping baby. He went into the nursery, laid him down, closed the door, and went to the den to watch the game. I finally relaxed and fell asleep. Rodney had the baby monitor with him, so I didn't wake up when baby started crying. I was so tired. I didn't even hear him crying in the nursery until Rodney flung the door open to go get him. I started to get up, but he closed the door and said he was back asleep. If you want to give me the monitor, I can take over. That power nap really did the trick. I'm feeling a lot better. No, I said I got it, so I got it. Don't act like I don't know how to be a parent. I know what I'm doing. I laid back down, but I didn't fall asleep. I just laid there and waited to hear baby. Not even 5 minutes later, baby starts screaming from the nursery. Before I was able to even stand up, Rodney was stomping up the stairs, and I could tell he was pissed. Asterisk speaking to himself, asterisk fuking baby needs to learn how to self-soothe or some sheet. This is fuking ridiculous. What fuking baby doesn't know how to fuking sleep? I should just let him sit there and cry himself to sleep, learn something for once, but knew, if Faye knew that she'd lose her mind, not dealing with her sheet on top of this too. Asterisk goes into the nursery, grabs baby, and stomps back downstairs while baby is wailing. I run out into the TV room, and I will never forget the look on Rodney's face, asterisk. Rodney was sitting on the couch, with a look of just pure rage in his eyes, glaring at the TV. Baby was sitting on his leg, and he was bouncing him. But it was clear it wasn't to soothe baby, but to try and calm his own rage. I'm sorry, he's not easy at bedtime. I'll get him to sleep. Thank you so much for your help, though. I grab baby from Rodney and he immediately starts to calm down, which only served to make Rodney more angry. I work my ass off for this family, day in and day out. All I wanted to do was watch a damn football game. And I've missed half of it because you refused to actually be a parent and sleep train that baby. I know, I'm sorry. I will start researching some gentle sleep training methods first thing in the morning. I really appreciate you trying to help me tonight though. That's not good enough. He's too damn spoiled. You need to just let him cry it out and he'll learn he can't scream like that. He's just a baby, Rodney. I'm not going to let him cry himself to sleep. We can figure out a different way. If you weren't going to be willing to do the difficult part of being a fuking mom, you should have just had an abortion or lost this baby like you lost all the others. He has ruined our fuking lives. I laid in bed that night and slept next to a man I realized I didn't know. How could I be married to someone who truly wished our son shouldn't be alive? I knew I made a mistake rushing to marry him when we found out about our first pregnancy before I lost that baby. My friends and family were right to warn me against it. But I wanted to give our baby a family so badly. I knew I had to leave, but I felt so trapped. I had no savings, and I was terrified that Rodney would try to keep baby from me if I left. And what happens if he wanted custody and hurt baby when I wasn't there? I saw how much anger Rodney truly had inside of him now, and it terrified me. I saw how he was quick to lash out in anger towards me, and how he had no patience for baby when he was crying. I saw how he was quick to punish the dogs for minor things, and how his punishments were grossly overreactive. I did my best to shield baby and the dogs from his temper. But with the dogs, I could not protect them every time. How am I supposed to leave and risk Rodney having visitation with baby without me there to protect him? How am I supposed to get out with baby? I have baby's daycare bag packed for tomorrow and his outfit and everything you'll need laid out for the morning. He has to be there by 8 a.m. at the latest, okay? Why are you telling me this? You always do drop-offs. I have to be at the hospital for my shift at 5 a.m. Remember, I told you this the other day.
You never told me that. I would have remembered. And didn't you tell the hospital you can't work that shift? It doesn't work with daycare.
I did tell you. I put it on the fridge too, and I told them. But everyone has to work this shift occasionally. They can't just never schedule me for it.
That's bullshit. So I'm supposed to just handle everything in the morning. How am I supposed to get to work on time? You might have to wake up like 30 minutes earlier than normal, but it's only for one day, then I won't have to do it again for a few weeks. You better not make this a regular thing, or I'm going to be the one speaking to the hospital, and I can't guarantee you'll have a job once I'm done. Baby woke up way before you said he would. You said he wakes up at 7:30, and he woke up way before that. I didn't even have any damn time to fix my beard or anything. I'm leaving the damn dogs outside. They won't shut the fuck up. I can't deal with them. And what bullshit did you pack for my lunch? You know I don't eat that shit. So why would you waste my time and yours packing it? We've been married for how long and you don't even know what your husband likes for lunch yet? It's crazy how you expect me to just take on your responsibilities and you can't even text me back to help. Why am I expected to just do this all by myself? I didn't make this baby on my own, did I? Where are my goddamn work pants? Can you not even do the laundry right so that I have what I need in the morning? I bet you made sure you had everything you needed though. This is fucking bullshit. I'm never doing this again. Understand me. They want you to work this shift again. They better figure out childcare. You want to stress me out so bad in the morning. Don't be surprised when I end up having a heart attack and on a living from your bullshit. What is going on? I can't have my phone while I'm working. That's why I didn't answer. Did baby get to daycare okay? What's going on is you're as sorry as she'd excuse for a mother who puts a damn job over her baby and husband. You should have made sure you didn't have to work this shift. But you wanted to make sure you screwed me instead. And the woman who runs that daycare is a bitch. Fuck her. She thinks she can give me sheet because I forgot baby's blanket. It's a fucking blanket. Too bad. They should have extra. It's his comfort object. He has a hard time going to sleep without it. That's why they were asking where it was. That's bullshit. He doesn't need that single blanket to fall asleep. It's just laziness and excuses. And by the way, I'm so fucking serious about never doing this again. Do you know how embarrassing it was to drop him off? Not one single man is there handling that. It's only women. Do I look like a fucking woman to you? I'm not giving up my time in the morning to do your woman's work. Plan your sheet better. Or find a new job. This is over. I was scheduled to work Saturday at the hospital, which meant that Rodney had to watch the baby since daycare was not open. This had happened a few times at this point. And there were never any major issues, so I felt okay about leaving baby with him. While I was getting ready that morning, Rodney needed something for baby from the store. I decided to run and grab it before work so he wouldn't have to deal with driving baby in the car. I was gone for 10 minutes before Rodney began to call me. Where the fuck are you? You need to get home now. I went to grab the thing for baby you said you needed. I'll be home in 15 minutes. What's wrong? What's wrong is a fucking baby got into the cabinets in the kitchen that you didn't fucking lock and spilled food fucking everywhere. And who is stuck cleaning it up? Me. You need to get home now and help me because I don't know where you put the damn paper towels this time. And I shouldn't have to clean all this up when it's your fault it happened. I'm on my way home. I'm sorry I left the baby lock off. I must have forgotten. It's not the lock. It's the fact you coddle him and don't give him any damn consequence. I rushed back to the house as fast as I could. I could hear baby screaming and crying in the background of the phone call. And I was terrified that Rodney had finally lost his temper completely with him. When I got home, Rodney was slammed cabinet doors and cursing, and baby was screaming and snotting, red-faced, in his pack and play. There was a very minor spill of oatmeal in the kitchen. This is bullshit, Faye. And how am I even supposed to clean this sheet up without paper towels? Wait a minute, where's the stuff you went to get from the store? I didn't get it. I came home to help you. You were really upset, and baby was crying. I was worried. You were worried? Worried about what? You think I was going to hurt baby? Are you fucking kidding me? Is that what you think of me? You've really fucking changed since you had baby. You only ever care about him. It's time you step the fuck up and be a wife and care about me too. I should come first. Rodney, I can't do this anymore. I'm leaving. Go ahead and leave. We don't need you. You don't do shit anyways. Asterisk, I begin to walk towards baby to grab him. And he grabs baby and refuses to give him to me. Asterisk. Rodney, I am leaving and baby is coming with me. You don't take care of him ever. Except on very rare occasions. You don't want to be solely responsible to take care of him every day. Asterisk begins to grab baby. Supplies and dog supplies. Asterisk. You aren't taking my kid or my dogs. You don't get to take sheet from me. You want to leave, get out, but everything else stays. Please give me baby or I'm going to call the police. I don't want to have to do that. Call them for what? Because I won't let you take everything from me. You don't get to do that, Faye. You aren't in charge here. Asterisk stomps around screaming. At this point, baby is hysterical. The dogs are hiding in terror. And I realize that I hit my dad's phone number when I grabbed my phone and he was on the line. I hang up to call 911 when I hear an "You seriously called the police? When did you do that? On the way home, you were planning this the entire time, weren't you?" "No, I never even got the chance to call. Someone else must have with all the yelling." Asterisk goes to the front door and cracks it open just barely to talk. Asterisk. "Hi, officer. I'm sorry for the confusion here, but we don't need police assistance. Everything is fine." I realize that this is the only chance I can safely speak to the police about what was happening without having any protection. I run over to the door and rip it open all the way. "Everything is not okay. I'm trying to leave a really bad situation, and my husband is refusing to let me take baby or our dogs with me to attempt to force me to stay with him. I am afraid for our safety and I need help to leave. Please help me.